We're going to talk about your brother in a bit, but first let's talk about your cousin.
The speaker. You said all my relatives this morning, is it? this afternoon. Okay.
All right, so let's talk about that. First, you had a lot of allegations saying that there was communication, messaging coming from the, or messages coming from the speaker's office. Yeah, talking about.
They weren't allegations. They're facts. I have them on my phone.
Exactly. That's what I wanted to talk to you about. What is your proof that, in fact, all these communication and messages were coming from the speaker's office? You also mentioned a name, Jethro Co. Yes. What's your proof for saying this, Senator?
Well, it's on my phone, and it's on the phones of many, many other lawmakers and city mayors. A lot of our mayors and friends have been asking me, is this the approval of the administration? What is this? I actually got a timeline long before Christmas. Around December 15, I think this got underway. And actually, I will be pursuing the investigation regarding the vote buying that has been alleged and the promise of $20 million for every congressional district that could produce the 20,000 signatures by January 12. So I will be pursuing that investigation. And I must say that the media has not been remiss in collating all the material. There are endless videotapes. There are many, many witnesses. There are photographs. There's all sorts of evidence that, in fact, these offers were made.
Do you think that these offers were made without the knowledge of the speaker, Senator?
It's unlikely because the numbers that were utilized were from the office of the speaker. In the beginning, I thought it could have just been some random text, but later on I realized that they were being followed up from the office of the speaker with staff and attorneys that are clearly employees there.
Which brings me now to an earlier interview that you had, Senator Marcos, and this is what you said. You said, para namang napipili natin ang kamag-anak natin. Okay naman si Martin dati. Hindi ko naman akalain na magkakaganito. Akala ko naman ay susunod lang siya. Hindi ko maintindihan kung saan galing to. Susunod sa alin, Senator?
Well, susunod sa kumpas ng presidente. Sinabi na nga ng presidente na wag na muna tutukan yung tsa-tsa at marami pa tayong problema. Eh, ba't hindi sumunod? Ngayon, sinabi na nga napaka-divisive ng Project PI nila. Abay, hindi pa rin sumusunod. Ang nangongolekta ngayon ng signature, eh, yung mga public works contractors naman. Akala ko, titigil na kasi divisive nga. So, this is becoming very problematic, and as I've said also repeatedly, lahat naman tayo may kamag-anak na kung minsan eh pasaway. Abay, pagtsagaan na lang ninyo ako, talagang hindi natin napipili ang kamag-anak.
Senator, which of the two is happening as we speak? Is it, you know, family issues causing the divisiveness, or is it politics getting in the way of family?
Well, I come from an intensely political family, and unfortunately, in my mind, trabaho lang, ano? Kapag hindi kayo nagkasundo sa isang issue, okay lang yon. Pero ito, nagiging malalim, at alam ko na si Martin, si Speaker, may tampo sa akin pagkat sabi niya, kumakampi daw ako sa Duterte. And that was around October, I felt na may tampo nga dahil binabakbakan nga si Vice President Sara, tapos inupak-upakan din si Presidente Duterte tungkol sa ICC. Abay, sabi ko, ba't naman ginaganyan? These are our allies, these are our friends, they have been true and loyal to us. There is no reason to pick a fight. This will be a golden age for Philippine politics if we can get it together and keep the solid north and the solid south. We have nothing better to think of except development, progress, and all the needs of our people. Why are we picking fights? So I think there was some resentment because of my very adamant defense of the Duterte portion of our unit team.
Which brings me to the next question, Senator Marcos. Where does your loyalty to family end, and where does your loyalty to the Dutertes begin?
Well, I don't think that Duterte have put me in any position where I am conflicted. What is very clear to me is that for family duty, I'm always there and I can always be counted on for help and support. However, the fact of the matter is I was voted into the Senate and into public office in the past by the Filipino people. I was not voted as a relative. Therefore, ang primary responsibility ko ay talaga sa mga bumoto sa akin, ang mamayang Pilipino. Laging mauuna ang bansa kaysa sa kamag-anak.
There was also this observation, Senator Marcos, that you're saying the Duterte line, you're towing the Duterte line. How much of where you stand now is of your own thinking, and how much of it is really about showing loyalty to the Dutertes?
I have no need to show loyalty to the Dutertes. I am simply a loyal person by nature and by family tradition. Many question the fact that there are Marcos loyalists list after so many decades. And the truth is there are loyalists because we too are loyal to them. And that is the only reason they continue to persist and exist. The loyalty to the Dutertes is simply derived from the fact that they have been good friends and political allies. And more importantly, it should be noted that President Duterte, as his daughter, the vice president, really hew the same independent and sovereign line that my father always espoused. It is my father's legacy to which I am loyal.
And finally, before we end this discussion, Senator Marcos, let's talk about you being a sister. I mean, you set out on this journey. You wanted your brother to succeed. And with the divergence that's happening right now, how does that make you feel?
Well, I'm distraught about the tension within the unity now, and I hope we are still able to patch things together. And I continue in my role as the self-appointed super ate ng Pangulo. At alam naman natin, kapag ate o sa Ilocano, kapag manang ka, pinagsasabihan mo ang mga kamag-anak at kapatid kapag hindi na tama ang gawa. Kahit pakinggan ka, kahit hindi ka pakinggan, dapat lamang sabihin mo ang totoo. Yun ang inaasahan sa nagmamahal na ate.
At this point, nakikinig ko ba, Senator?
Palagay ko nakikinig naman kasi wala naman masyadong imik yung kapatid ko, pero sa bandang huli, mukha naman magkapareho pa rin kami at magkapatid pa rin dahil nga kami ay tapat sa legasiya at pinamana ng aking ama.
Senator Amy Marcos there joining us this noon. Thanks again for taking our call. Really appreciate it.
Thank you very much, Carmina, and thank you to all those who are listening.
Thanks again. Take care.